guys. Here is your video explanation for your review. I'm going to go over hopefully most of it. Make sure you have set up and actually correct answers. Only a partial key will be posted on Canvas, so if you need explanation or help, please take the time to watch the video. Like always, complete the review, turn it in tomorrow. It will be bonus points onto your test score. So to start off, the first problem, I'm hoping you see, and I will use highlighters to help you see some of the parts a lot better. We should see that we have two chords here. So whenever we have two chords that intersect, we should hopefully see chord-chord rule, which means we're going to do part times part. So if I look at the part on my yellow chord, that is the 14 times the x. I'm going to use parentheses to show multiplication. And then on my green chord, that's the 10 times 21. So really, this is simplified to 14x equals 210. And then we're solving for x just by dividing by 14 on both sides. And x is 15. So all they want you to do on here is to solve for x. So on number two, it's the same rule, okay? If you're not too sure which chords we're looking at, remember, don't mix up your parts. We should have a chord with 15 and 8 parts and x and 12. So you do that one, you should get a whole number greater than 5 if you did it correctly. So I should take care of that. All right, now when we get to 3 and 4, what we have shown on 3 and 4 are two tangents. And whenever we have two tangents coming from the same point, they are congruent tangents. So they didn't mark it on here, but you could put tick marks between LK and JK. Or you can think of AKA conehead. So if you see that it makes a conehead, the parts in that cone head are going to be congruent. So to set this up, we should have 19x, I believe it's plus 2, equals 20x. And we're just solving for x first. So I can do that by just subtracting the 19x, which gives me 2 equals x. But they want us to find the length of JK. So now you have to plug it in. Don't forget that step. That will happen on the test for sure. So JK is the 20 times 2, which is the x, 20x. So this comes out to be 40. Okay. So again, they want you to find the length of JK using conehead. So hopefully we see our JL is congruent to our JK to set it up. We should start off with our 2x minus 15 equals x minus 3. Go ahead and solve for x and plug it in and solve for JK. Okay, I think you got that. Now the next type of problem you're going to have will be, and you can pause the video anytime if you want to finish this or go back, but on this one, hopefully you should be seeing that you have a tangent whenever a segment or a line touches a circle exactly at one point. You have a tangent, and we have a diameter, and every diameter has a part, which is the radius, and that whenever they meet, they are perpendicular. This is our tangent theorem, which basically states that the tan, I'm going to abbreviate, is always perpendicular to the radius. And with that being said, we're going to use Pythagorean theorem to solve problems like this. This was on the worksheet that you did when I was absent, on the video explanation I gave you, and on the green notes. Make sure we're studying those items, especially the green notes, the recap notes, to help you prepare. So when I plug in our parts, our legs are a squared and 15 squared, because always opposite the right angle is the C, hypotenuse. So we're just going to do A squared plus 15 squared equals C squared, which is our 64 and 225, excuse me, equals C squared. When you add those together, we should get 289. Equals C squared, and we're going to take the square root, because we have to left off for C. So don't forget to take your square root, and our C is 17. So number 6 is just like number 5, okay? Even though you have decimals, don't worry about that. Put that in the calculator. Get your decimal answer. Don't round. So our setup should be our 8.4. You might want to use parentheses if you need to make sure you're squaring it correctly. Plus 11 squared equals C squared. So what I'm saying is when you get your 8.4 and you square it, you should get 70.56. So don't round it. Keep the decimal. Plus, you should have an answer here. Equals C squared. I want you to solve for C. I think you can do this. You've shown me you can do this many times. All right, now this next section here on 7 and 8, they want you to find the radian measure. So they want you to go from degrees to radians. Anytime you go from degrees to radians, you remember what you're going to have to do? That should be just the end. You're going to multiply, and I'm going to abbreviate that, multiply by pi over 180. Okay? So, what we have over here on number 7 is 220 degrees. I'm now going to multiply that by pi over 180. Remember, this is like 220 over 1. So top times top, bottom times bottom. This gives me 220 pi over 180. Then in the calculator, you're only going to focus on the 220 divided by 180. That's going to give us a fraction answer because we're going to keep pi in our answer. So this comes out to be, I believe, 10 pi over 9. Or you could write it as 10 ninths pi, okay? Either way would work. So you have number 8. It's a nice, easy one. Comes out to be a whole number. We did it correctly. Now, on the last problems here, 9 and 10, excuse me. They want you to write the equation of the circle. So the equation of a circle has this form, x minus h, parentheses squared, plus y minus k, parentheses squared, equals c squared. This is what we did on our, I believe, our blue notes. Was a graphic organizer with the equation of a circle. No, it was yellow, sorry. Our yellow notes. So what we're going to do is we need to plug in our parts. So here, your center always has a form of h comma k. And then we need our radius. Our radius is 4, but oops, and I put c squared over here. I apologize. I'm sorry. This should equal r squared. My bad. So we know that r is 4, but we're going to do r squared. So that's 16. So now we're just plugging in the parts into the form. So where my 7 is, I'm putting for h. Where my 13 is, I'm putting in for k. And so I also want to talk about what happens when we plug in. So I want you to notice something. Just substitute x minus 7, parentheses squared, plus your y minus a negative 13, parentheses squared, and we already know our radius squared is 16. So right here, because we're subtracting a negative, really this is y plus 13 squared. And everything else stays the same. So just to remind you that whenever we plug it into the formula, we do opposite of what we see. So this is positive here. The 7 was positive. But over here, it becomes minus 7. The 13 was negative 13, but over here now it became a positive 13. So remember, you're doing the opposite when you're plugging it in. And the same thing when you're taking it out. So here on 10, here's your center. Here's your radius. Remember, we're using radius square. So you need that number. And you're just plugging it into your form, x minus h, parentheses squared, plus y minus k, parentheses squared, equals radius squared, not c squared. I apologize on that. All right, so that takes care of your first page. If you just hit the fast forward button, because this is a playlist, it'll go to the next page. Thank you for getting your review done and preparing for your test.